The acclaimed Neuralink brain chip could be the most challenging and compelling development Elon Musk is embarking on, and is making headlines for its controversial brain chip interface. Fans are now wondering whether possessing a chip that could instantaneously connect to the internet would make humans more intelligent. What will the price be? What is it exactly intended to do? And what are potential future risks? Welcome to Futured, for your daily dose of future technology, Elon Musk, and SpaceX content. In today's video, we'll discuss how Neuralink will alter humanity's future. Is it possible that it may be used to treat blindness, disabilities, paralysis, or even mental disorders? Or is it just going to be a Fitbit inside of your head? Let's take a look at where this future age of technology is leading to, some of the practical ramifications, and how you could develop a company around brain implants. Before we jump in, make sure to like and subscribe to our channel. Let's get started. Musk launched Neuralink in 2016, but was first publicly announced in March 2017. Neuralink is a company developing implantable brain-machine interfaces with the goal of creating breakthrough technology for the brain. Elon said that the device could scan brain patterns, which a computer can interpret. Neuralink has a lot of promise for human brain activity study and enhancement. And in the previous several months, it has also made several intriguing discoveries. There have been many assumptions and hypotheses about what this type of technology might achieve, but we haven't in real life yet. Neuralink belongs to a small subset of technology known as brain-computer interface, or BCI. Scientists have been inserting probes into people's brains for decades, so this isn't exactly cutting-edge technology. However, what sets Neuralink apart is that they've been developing a product with a broader appeal. The technology is being marketed as something that everyone, not just people with disabilities or injuries, would desire. This is particularly noteworthy given that a Neuralink is an invasive BCI, which is directly attached to the user's brain. Non-invasive and somewhat invasive devices are also commercially available, although they don't perform nearly as effectively. You've definitely seen the non-invasive gadgets, which looks like strange headgear with sensors all over. It can detect your brainwaves, however, with little clarity. Imagine you're standing across the street from a rock concert taking place inside an arena. You'd pick up enough of the music to realize that songs were being performed, but you wouldn't be able to identify the tune. Changing to an invasive BCI is like standing at the front row at a concert when all of the subtleties of the performance are amplified. The difficulty with all these invasive BCI technologies so far has been that they need brain surgery to install the implant, which has, predictably, limited their acceptance rate. The Neuralink business model is based on their gadget being inserted by an automated robot surgeon, making the operation as simple and routine as laser eye surgery. Now, how cool is that? Would you undergo this surgery? And that's just not it. They might potentially reach tens of thousands, if not millions, of individuals. This would be the first consumer electronic gadget to be implanted. As a result, Neuralink's business concept is likely to be successful. So, with all that in mind, let's have a look at what this device is capable of and how much it will cost you. The comparisons between Neuralink with laser eye surgery will be drawn often, and this is because Neuralink is essentially following the same corporate strategy as LASIK. Elon has stated that the cost of a Neuralink setup will eventually be close to the price of a laser eye operation. Essentially, we're speaking about the distant future. Even before Neuralink enters the market, it must first get through years of medical studies, and early adopters will have to pay a higher price to be the first in line. However, if all goes according to plan, the cost of a Neuralink setup in the United States should be approximately $5,000. The technology should be pretty affordable, particularly as technology advances over time. Thus, the technology falls in a price range that most people could afford if they really believed it was worth it. Which leads to the following question. What will this device be capable of doing? Things start to get a little problematic at this point, because Elon Musk and his crew have been making a lot of promises about what this device is capable of. We've heard it all from treating spinal cord injuries, curing Parkinson's disease, mending mental illness, and even offering digital immortality. The MIT Technology Review released an article that stated, "Neuralink is neuroscience theater, and Elon made promises that will be hard to keep during his event." Many fact tests for the Neuralink idea were provided by MIT, which pointed out that most of these difficulties may be hard to tackle, even with the greatest technology. For example, if we want to treat sadness by altering the inner workings of someone's brain, we'll need first to figure out what electrochemical imbalances are causing sadness in the first place. Even if you have a workshop full of the most incredible equipment, you won't be able to repair a vehicle if you don't know how it works. As a result, Neuralink's potential as a miraculous solution to humanity's problems may be exaggerated, but it doesn't rule out the possibility of it becoming really valuable in the future. Let's take a closer look at the Neuralink human trials. The chip is placed in the person's skull, and it allows individuals to use their thoughts to control computers. It may eventually connect the brain with the internet too. This indicates that individuals will have instant access to Google and other search engines, making them much smarter. However, it's important to mention that Neuralink's goal is to create a symbiotic relationship between humans and AI. Even though the process may connect them, Neuralink will always be a device that individuals use. It will only interpret brain processes and translate them into an algorithm that a computer can comprehend after it is installed. Neuralink can only read ideas and cannot take over the brain's cognitive functions. Experts accept, however, that it might do considerable harm to an individual, especially in terms of mobility, as a user may experience digital death, rendering them handicapped in the worst-case scenario. That sure sounds scary. But how exactly does Neuralink work? It's essential to understand the science behind the human brain before learning how Neuralink works. Neurons in the brain provide information to cells throughout the body, muscles, nerves, glands, as well as other neuron cells. A neuron cell consists of the dendrite, a cell body or soma, and axon. Each component has a distinct purpose. The dendrite receives the signals, which are processed by the soma. The signals are subsequently sent to the other cells through the axon. Synapses are the interconnections between neurons that release neurotransmitters. These chemical compounds are then delivered to the dendrite of yet another neuron cell, allowing current to flow across the neurons. The electrodes that make up the Neuralink will detect electrical signals generated by a number of neurons in the brain. After that, the signals are supplied in the form of an action or motion. According to the company's website, the gadget is implanted directly in the brain since it cannot correctly detect the signals generated by the brain if it is placed outside the skull. But when will this chip be available? We still don't have a launch date for the Neuralink chip since the technology has to be tested on people first. And if a prior projection is reached, Neuralink could move from monkey testing to human trials within a year, which is surprisingly fast. Now that they raised another $205 million in funding in August 2021, it will bring them even closer. So folks, we're in for a crazy ride in the future. When this device exactly will be coming, we don't know, but it's just a matter of time. Would you have a Neuralink implanted? Let us know your thoughts in the comment section below. Make sure to subscribe to our channel to never miss a video from us. That's it for today's video. Thank you for watching.